Kimetsu No Yaiba, loosely translated into Demon Slaying Sword, is one of the most underrated manga and anime right now in the mainstream, but with the upcoming anime produced by Ufotable with their colorful and mesmerizing animation that will portray the wicked demons and the people that are struggling to retain their humanity. The story centers around Tanjiro Kamado with his trademark rectangular earrings marked with a sun and a fiery scar on the top right of his forehead. He is a kind-hearted boy that gets along with everyone he meets, but he turns into a demon hunter who carries around a wooden box with his sister Nezuko, a demon that can't see the light of day. The relationship between these two are what drives the story forward. Tanjiro only has his sister left after losing his entire family. He did not fall into depression, but he strives for a change. And he has a commendable attitude. And Nezuko, who was turned into a demon, did not lose her humanity in the end, all thanks to the love that only a family member can provide. In his journey, he joins Hunter Corps, where he finds camaraderie with the aloof Tomika, part of the pillars, the top ranks in the Demon Hunter Corps, the nervous Zenitsu, and the eccentric Inosuke. What I find interesting about these characters is how they don't stick around longer than they need to. Unlike a certain other popular shonen series that boxed the story down with too many characters, these characters sticks around and grows alongside the main character for the period that they needed to be there. Let's look at Inosuke. When we first meet him, he was a beast, all out of control, but he slowly subdues and works alongside Tanjiro. Inosuke, who was raised by mountain pigs, learns about the kindness of humans and the courageous acts that they are capable of. Humanity is able to thus turn a wild beast back into someone that is capable of feeling sad for others in the end. The demon hunters use sword techniques that centers around breaths, based around principles of martial arts, where breathing in a rhythm can turn people into superhumans that is able to survive the vicious attacks of demons. These attacks are elemental base. There are fire, water, wind, and earth, and various others that are based on those elements. These techniques are relatively straightforward, but it gets interesting when they are met with the unique demon arts that demons use. The main antagonist of the story is Muzan Kibu Tsuchiji, the propragnator of the demons that has lived for over 1,000 years. He first appears as an elegant, handsome man with curly hair and a jet black suit, but throughout the story you see him changing into other forms, like a beautiful woman or a young boy. His goal is to overcome the weakness of demons and to conquer the sun. In order to do that, he has turned countless people into demons for the sake of his ambition. Under the leader of the demons are the fearsome beings known as the 12 Demon Moons. There are some demons with unique abilities that has lived for many years. They are split into the upper moons and the lower moons, where a number is engraved onto their eyes to signify their rankings. They are the most fearsome demons around. What I find most interesting about these demons is that they all have a tragic backstory to them. It tells you why they chose to give up their humanity to live as demons. The abilities of these demons reminds of early JoJo stand abilities and early Hunter x Hunter abilities. They are not too complicated, so that they require pages of monologues for someone to explain their inner workings, but they are also not as straightforward as just energy blasts and power levels. This creates fights with a perfect balance of good action scenes and some strategies mixed in. Alright, so this manga has some good protagonists and antagonists, and good fights too, but isn't that just the basic requirements for a shonen manga? Well, what's different about this manga is that it has heart. It makes you care about the characters as you understand them more and more. You understand what makes them laugh and cry, the pain they go through. It is not just some trendy manga that is taking advantage of the hero craze, or a manga that is built up on generic story structures that reminds you of past legendary manga. Yaiba is not afraid to be his own story, a story about the struggle, the deprived, and most importantly, humanity.